Absolutely fantastic result tonight. West Ham defeated Newcastle 2-0 at home. Great result. Joined by my dad.
Hi, guys.
First and foremost, let's get straight into, before we get into the game, the big news coming out was the name in the stand after the legend that is Billy Bonds. You know, disappointed I never got a chance to see him, but you know, you did.
I did.
And I mean, you've seen him, what, every week for years?
Absolutely.
I mean, how important was he?
He was a vital part to West Ham. I mean, they talk about the West Ham way, playing the fluent football and everything, but also we had that kind of determination and guts, and he epitomised that. So he used to get on that pitch and give everything and leave everything on the pitch.
Yeah, absolutely.
He was that good. He was brilliant. Tackler, tough. Occasionally, you know, maybe went in a bit too tough, but he was a great, great player, great servant to the team.
How important was it that with West Ham making the move to the London Stadium that we give Billy Bonds that stand?
Oh, he deserved it.
And for the fans as well.
Definitely deserved it. I mean, he's a fan's favourite. He was always a fan's favourite. Simply because, as I said, if you come off the pitch and you're a fan and you see somebody work as hard as he did and give as much as he did, you loved him. And that's what he was, loved by everybody.
Do you think it was, that's what maybe G'd up the West Ham players today, the West Ham squad, in preparation for it? Because there was that kind of atmosphere, you know, before the game, there was all that banter going on saying happy Billy Bonds Day, you know, do you think the players felt that? Do you think,
I think everybody felt that today. I mean, he when you're running one of your own and then and naming a stand after him like that, and he's there, and he's going to be an inspiration just being in the ground.
Absolutely.
And I think he would be, the reputation of goes before him, so all the team would know totally about him, and he was just a fantastic player.
We go on a lot about some players and comparisons into the modern squad. I mentioned it to you during the game tonight.
Yeah.
If you had to choose, and I'm not saying there is anyone exactly like him right now, because I don't think there is, but who's the closest player in our current squad? The closest, whether that's 50% of what he does to what Billy Bonds' style of play?
I said it really is difficult because he was really a one-off. Closest, I would say, in terms of tackling and stuff like that, would be Mark Noble. I mean, Mark kind of tackles in the same kind of determination as what Billy Bonds does. And also, I think Mark Noble generally leaves everything on the pitch as well, which is similar to Billy Bonds. Bonds was a little bit different. He was bigger than Noble. He was a big guy. He used to, he could intimidate as well as he could play good football, but he was a driving force. He drove a team from the back.
Yeah.
And he drove them up the park, you know, and he was there and he was always in the mix.
Yeah. But he's a local lad. Yeah. I mean, Mark Noble also is a local lad, which is fantastic.
From Charlton.
Yeah. But I mean, great thing. And you know what? Long may that continue. If West Ham, the board, finally listen to the fans like they've been doing and they make these small changes game in and week out that start to make and try and make us feel like this place is home, it's only going to add to the experience for the fans, which is hopefully going to relate to the players on the park. On tonight's game, we welcomed Newcastle. Benitez came off a two-game winning streak, came up against West Ham. What were your thoughts on team selection and in particular Lanzini starting?
Yes, well, I think Lanzini is a must to start, really. I mean, that creativity we've missed and he's back now, so why not play him up? You know, play him And I think he did show tonight some creative streaks, which he's got. You know, there's no question about him and Anderson together. I think they played really well, made a lot of good chances tonight.
They do look like they kind of thrive off each other. I mean, the biggest important thing for me is watching Lanzini's confidence coming off of a terrible injury like he had. Yes. But he's played the whole game tonight. He's not even been substituted off. Now, you know, there's this big common thing with West Ham that they talk about not being able to bring and reintegrate the players who have been injured back into the squad. They get injured again. Mm. Touch wood, they don't. But with Lanzini, you know, he's
class though, Tony, isn't he? He's got so much class there that how could you not integrate him back in?
Yeah.
I mean, he's got everything, really. On saying that, I would say like the likes of, obviously, we've not mentioned Declan Rice, but the way he plays, the way he kind of controls everything, really, a central midfield player, that must be like nectar to our players.
Absolutely.
You know, nectar.
When you look at that midfield positioning, you know, and we've said it week in and week out about even Martin Noble, how he kind of goes up and down. But I said to you during the game, I feel like Martin Noble plays off of the, you know, Declan Rice takes a lot of the responsibility in that team. He really shuts up shop when he needs to do it. He sprays balls.
Now he's scoring goals.
Goals with the penalties.
So another brilliant goal.
But to have the creativity alongside him with Lanzini and Anderson and then Snodgrass the workhorse, it gives Noble one job to do only, and he seems to do it reasonably well.
Yeah, he does.
And we can't take that away from him. No. Yeah, you know you're going to get fans and comments. Get the comments in below. Let us know your thoughts on what we are saying. But
he did well. I mean, he was a bit rough with one tackle.
It was rough with one tackle. Yeah,
lucky to get away with that. There
was no need for that tackle. No. That was the thing. The ball was going away.
It was going away from him. There was no need.
Goal. There was no need.
He could have got a red card on that.
Yeah, absolutely.
And that would have put us down to 10 men, but he didn't anyway. So.
With the game itself, quite an early goal for West Ham coming from a corner from Snodgrass, and that man we mentioned, Declan Rice, stepped up. I mean,
just miles above everybody, brilliantly placed. I mean, he just nodded it in as if it was like a on the training pitch.
Yeah, but he really is miles above everybody.
Oh, he is. He's great.
There was a bit of a comparison before the game where they were talking about this player Longstaff from Newcastle and Declan Rice, obviously from West Ham. And you know, it's tough when you've got two strong English players, and it's great. It's always good to have that battle in the middle of the field. But I mean, you can't really take your eyes off of Declan Rice even as a neutral fan, because he's so commanding in the midfield.
He
just, like I've said it many times before, he glides.
He's elegant.
He's
an elegant player.
And he glides with the ball.
Yeah, he does.
And he knows what he's doing. His spatial awareness, which is fantastic, which is something we have related to the Bobby Moore days, the spatial awareness.
And he loves that. He himself said he loves that.
He thrives
off
of it.
Of that midfield role. He loves it. Yeah, absolutely.
No brainer is going to step into that England side.
I hope so.
And should start. So he got the goal when West Ham went 1-0 up. We weren't really troubled by Newcastle in particular. And was that maybe down to the fact that, you know, Declan Rice was doing his job and the defence were doing their job, closing down?
I think the defence were good today, Diop was good. He made a couple of good tackles. Fabianski, of course, he made a fantastic save at the end there. So, I mean, you've got that strength still in the defence there, which is good to keep. You know, to keep a clean sheet was good today.
And I've got to give plaudits to Augie. I'm his biggest critic.
Yeah, I know, but he puts himself in there, doesn't he?
He's done well, and he's kind of thriving on that partnership with him. And all but, you know, having players coming back from injury like Balbuena and Winston Reid's going to always challenge you, and that's not a bad thing to have in a squad like West Ham. Creswell came off injured again. It's a bit disappointing.
Was just an unlucky clash of heads. It was a really nasty clash.
I don't think
it was
his head, though. I think it was his injury from his foot that came off.
I thought it was his head.
It was his head earlier on in the game, but I just think we're so inconsistent with injuries in that position right now, and we need to maybe look out for that in the future. Masuaku came on and gets a lot of slagging through the season, but he done all right tonight.
Did well. Slotted in. And just finished the job.
Done his job. And he looked pretty confident in a couple of the tackles. We've discussed the midfield, Snodgrass. I mean, Anderson and Lanzini partnership does look
very
quite exciting.
Very good. It is good. Yeah, I like that.
What was your thoughts on Chicharito?
Do you know, he was really unlucky. A beautiful ball that went into him there, and he kind of just took it down, and I thought he was going to finish that. I think he's good. He's in and around the box. He's not going to be every fan's favourite at the moment, but to be in and around the box for the opportunity of grabbing a goal in the 10-yard situation, then it's worth having him on.
He plays up top himself, which
is
disappointing.
It is difficult.
But what he is doing is doing things that a lot of fans have always said. He's working hard for the team now. And that's something we like to see. And he looks gutted when he comes off. Right enough, he does. And what was your thoughts on not starting Arnautovic?
I can't really comment on that because I don't know. If it was me, I would have started him today. I would have done, but there again, I don't know. Perhaps there's something there that Pellegrini wants to, you know, let him just recover a little bit, settle in a little bit more.
Yeah.
I think that's the Pellegrini way, you know. He's kind of reintroducing him to the team the way he's done today. But to be fair to Arnautovic, in the last couple of games when he has come on, he's done really well.
Yeah, absolutely.
I mean, he played well again when he came on tonight.
He did do actually well when he came on tonight. We got the penalty. For me, there was contact.
Chicharito
made the most of it.
Yeah.
He went down. Last week, we could have had Lanzini had a penalty, but he didn't against Man City. He stayed up, but, you know, that was a penalty.
Yeah, it was.
It wasn't the most stonewall penalty. Referees would have given it whatever, for me, it was a penalty.
Yeah.
And then Martin Noble stepped up. What a penalty that was.
That was a great penalty.
Top bins, they call that.
I know. I mean, the confidence in him is brilliant for that, isn't it?
Yeah, absolutely.
19 out of 21 now he's got.
Is that what it is? 19 out of 21 penalties. Fantastic. You know, that win tonight catapults West Ham up to 9th place. Uh-huh. We're on 39 points.
Uh-huh.
Safety number, hopefully. That's the biggest thing.
Thank God for
with
that.
With a certain amount of games to go.
Yeah.
We looked at the league there. 4 points from 7th place. Quick question for you, Dad, is do you want European football for next season?
I think any fan would love European football. I love European football. I mean, I haven't said, I've seen European football, so I'd like really the fans to be able to see perhaps some of the samples, some of the stuff that I saw. And I'd like to see us there. But at the same time, I suppose if you look further down the line and think that perhaps that could be with our squad, that could be quite a demanding season with having that on, I don't know.
Yeah.
But I think everybody would like European football. Would you not like European football?
I mean, of course I would. But, you know, there's always that bit of worry that it's maybe a slightly too early. We've seen so many seasons before. In recent years, that we've started the season too early. We've played too many games. It has an impact on our season. I suppose it depends on the business we do in the summer.
It's going to be tough to get into the position for European. Because of Wolves and them type of teams that run. Wolves and Everton are the teams that I think we're chasing a bit there now.
But it's funny, it's like a contradicting comment. Do I want European football? And I'm sitting here saying I'm not sure, but I want to finish as high up the league as possible.
Yeah, of course.
So do you know what? If we get European football, we get it. Just do it. And why not? I mean, it's a confidence boost for West Ham going into the next game.
Absolutely.
It's a result we wanted. It's a
result we needed. Remember, we're excited with the Intertoto Cup, so we'd be excited with the Europa Cup.
Exactly. And then obviously you've seen better than that.
I've seen better than that.
As well. So make sure you get your comments in below. Let us know your thoughts. What we're going to do is we're going to pass over to Stel and Dan live at the London Stadium. They're going to do a quick
video. Here and we've just beat Newcastle 2-0 at the ground. I'm joined by Maltese Hammers. What did you make of the game?
I think we really played good. We deserved the win. We played defensively good. We got the 2 goals in the first half. We didn't concede in the second half. So I think we did pretty good. We deserved the win.
Brilliant. And you deserve to see a win. Say your name.
Dean Faruja. I'm from Malta. This is the 8th time visiting West Ham away and home. And this is the first time that I've seen them winning.
He came at the beginning of the week and you went to Manchester City.
Yes, Tuesday we landed in Manchester. We saw the match on Wednesday, Man City away. We lost 1-0 to a penalty that wasn't. We played defensively good once again. Then we travelled to London and finally I've seen West Ham winning.
Brilliant. We've done well today. Let's have Catherine with a Q. She's got a one-word analysis.
Supercalifragilisticexpialidocious.
There we go. And we got Robert Snodgrass, his biggest fan. What do you think? Brilliant. He loves Robert Snodgrass. We've got Paul here. Paul, what'd you make of the game?
Loved it, mate. Yeah, solid performance. Closing down quickly. Fuck off. Excellent game, mate.
See you later. Maltese Hammers are leaving. Thank you very much. See you later. You liked it?
Yeah, proper game, mate. Solid performance. Nice, closed him down. That's what it's about, mate. Yeah. Didn't give him a chance, mate.
And for Bonzo as well.
Bonzo, what?
It would have been terrible if we lost this one.
Loved it, mate. Good to see him. You know, it was emotional and it was solid. The songs, you know. Got to sing that every game, right? Billy Bonzo out for the army. He's a legend, mate. Legend.
Billy.
Oh, I love that song, yeah.
6'2", eyes are blue, was named to stand after you. Sweet Billy Bonzo. And on to the next.
Thanks very much, Stel. Anyway, make sure you get your comments in here below. Subscribe to the channel. And fantastic result tonight. Any last thing? Man of the match?
No. Oh, man. Well, I think he got it, didn't he, Lanzini?
Lanzini, 100%. Absolutely deserved it tonight. Yeah. I can't believe this guy's come back from this injury and done so well.
No, he has, yeah.
Anyway, he's been my dad. I've been Anton. Come on, you Irons.
On the Irons.